welcome. Thank you for joining today's session on creating an integrated architecture for an intelligent digital supply chain. My name is Robert Noce, and I'm a Chief Development Architect at Digital Supply Chain here at SAP. I'm also driving the architecture within the Industry 4 Now program. So in today's session, we're going to focus on taking a look at the Industry 4 Now vision. We'll take a look at the enabling technologies and really set the context behind what our discussion is about today. I'll then look into the target solution blueprint and say a few words about the software stack evolution. You know, how did we get to the architecture that we're looking at today? And that'll lead us into the reference architecture component. So we'll talk about the reference architecture, look at some of the guiding principles that go into the architecture. And then lastly, we'll do a quick hands-on in our enterprise architecture designer tool and really look at the implementation of the architecture and show off some great assets that are available to you on our API business hub. So really to frame the discussion and look at where we're coming from with Industry 4 Now, it's great to take a look at what you may have seen in previous TechEds and in other presentations, you know, really centering around the intelligent enterprise. So the intelligent enterprise bringing together our end-to-end business processes from the front office all the way to the back office. And a key component of this, which I'm happy to represent, is the digital supply chain area in the middle. With the Industry 4 Now program, it really centers around bringing Industry 4.0 industrial transformation in a very clear and concise delivery within our suite of products. And really, we center around four key themes within Industry 4.0. That's really about intelligent product, intelligent factory, intelligent assets, and empowered people. So when we look at the technologies, when we look at the applications, it's about logistics, it's about our design applications, it's about manufacturer, all sorts of different elements that are key to the supply chain and making the supply chain intelligent. If you've joined last year, or if you're familiar with some of these details on the intelligent enterprise, you may also know of design to operate. So that's really a description of the end-to-end business process that takes place from design to operate. And it fits as a good glue behind the technology enablers to the themes, and really about extending into other areas of the intelligent enterprise. So for example, connecting with our customers to understand their sentiment that goes into the design. So feedback loops with customer. It also means tying into our HR systems when we're looking at resource planning on shop floor. So understanding what worker availability, what worker certifications are. So it really does go beyond those four walls. It does go beyond the particular business process and extends really left to right looking at this graphic. Today's discussion will also focus a bit on the technology enablers. We see cloud computing, Internet of Things, edge computing, industrial big data management as some key elements behind making this architecture a reality. Solution Blueprint is a great view that I like to show. It really overlays, you know, something typical like the Purdue model on the left, where we have physical things, sensing control, layer two with monitoring, all the way up to our typical ERP and operations and business networks. You get a good sense of the applications that make part of these layers. You also visually see the need to integrate your shop floor components, your warehouse components, your assets as part of that process. So really a lot of this intelligent supply chain is about taking machine data, taking this process data, having context behind it, having business context so that we can have data-driven decisions. So we can understand what the machine was doing at the time of certain behaviors. It's also key to understand that we have a digital thread that's part of all of these processes. Some of the technology highlights that you'll also see in the architecture are how we've enabled a cloud-governed edge lifecycle. That means we'll take some edge components, we'll take some business processes, and actually not only have them run in the cloud, but also have them deployed and running on the edge. So that's really key to bringing together these various layers. And the next slide, we'll talk a little bit about the evolution of that data stack, software stack. So I like to show this just before I get into the architecture because it sets some background as to how things have evolved. So in traditional ISA 95 in this stack here, we see very clear delineation from what we might have on factory floors from sensors and machines, clear interfaces from the PLC up to the factory, up to the corporate level. Where things have shifted is machines and devices are now connected everywhere. Data is being pumped into industrial data lakes from different areas, from different levels. Our applications are much more distributed now. We're taking advantage of cloud computing and the edge computing and IoT that we'll again see in our reference architecture. And integration is at all levels. So it's good to see that, you know, where things were and how we're evolving, crossing these boundaries. And I like to center a little bit around the industrial data lake because that's key to ensuring that we have control over our data, that we have proper access, and we're delivering data to the right personas, whether it's a data scientist or a business analyst, that we're delivering them the right amount of data in their particular context. So what's great about this view now is looking at all of the components that we put together to form this intelligent supply chain. This architecture centers on a few key principles, and maybe I'll call those out now before I walk through certain elements of the architecture itself. The key guiding principles behind this are the architecture is secure, it's interoperable, portable, there's openness, it's affordable and extensible. So if I take a couple of these examples and why I bring them up as guiding principles, it's important to have, as an example, secure communications. Since we are wiring in cyber physical systems, you know, wiring into our assets, we're looking at machinery, AGVs, it's really important to have secure communication because as we move to consuming applications, as you see here across the top, that would be residing in the cloud, that information is very critical for employee safety, for IP, you know, protecting data is really key behind all of this. And we mitigate that by running them through the channels and the products that you see here on the screen. Second element is interoperable. It's very important that this architecture is interoperable with other products, with other providers. So we see examples of that throughout the bottom. The ability to also consume cloud provider IoT data to tie into other data sources that may be available in your enterprise or non-SAP systems and SAP systems alike that may be on-premise or in private cloud or hosted. Another element is portability. It's really important to have in an intelligent supply chain, portability of these business processes. So if we're developing logic, if we're developing microservices as an example that reside in the cloud, well, really we want that flexibility to be able to develop once and deploy anywhere. We have that in examples of our digital manufacturing cloud and cloud edge solutions where we have execution that could happen in the cloud, but also support execution scenarios in upcoming releases where an edge appliance is connected and managed with lifecycle components in the cloud, but providing that portability of that logic running both cloud and edge close to the machinery, close to the operators. That last aspect or the another aspect of openness is really key here. And we see that quite a bit on edge. We see that in machine onboarding as an example. So being able to support automation ML. When it's up to machine connectivity scenarios, we talk about connectivity standards and open standards like OPC UA, Modbus, EtherCAT, and our technologies that you see on the left under the edge box, things like SAP Plant Connectivity, also known as Pico, and Edge Services, they'll support a multitude of these open standards. We also have open standards just in the development of the microservices themselves. So they're containerized and they run both in Cloud Foundry and Kubernetes. So we have a strategy that allows us to have openness in the runtimes as well. Another area is extensibility. So when we look at how customers and partners and how our applications and processes are extended, we look to things like the business technology platform on the bottom right there. So we have technologies that allow for extensible extension creation. And that's really about bringing additional value, allowing allowing you and the entire ecosystem to build on the benefits of the processes that we're and the products that we're delivering here. And lastly, about affordability. So when we talk about affordability, it's not just about computational affordability, so where we run our applications. Really, cloud applications have evolved and have taken prominence because of the ability to scale, to have lower cost of ownership, to share resources. But that affordability also extends to things like data management. So when we look at industrial data management, we have options to manage the time series data, as an example, in our SAP IoT portfolio. But also the choice exists and options exist to have that information managed or to bring your own data lake into the mix. And in both of those scenarios, we look to smart data tiering scenarios and options that the underlying technology brings. So not all data is maintained in hot storage. We look to warm and cold storage. And that's both in the SAP managed and also what we look to our cloud providers and our hyperscaler partners for. Another aspect of portability is the ability to, you know, support multiple hyperscalers. So we do deploy our systems on multiple hyperscalers, and that's really the advantage of building on our business technology platform. So as I wrap up this architecture slide, I want to review a couple of the key items behind the technology. And that's really the edge, as I described, our, you know, connectivity to shop floor warehouses, things like AGVs. Edge brings the data. We process it in the cloud. We process it through components like our edge services and our Internet of Things, our IoT components. We center the information on master data. So we have Asset Central and other components where we are tracking that information centrally. And that's really what's enabling the cross-application consumption across the top. So multiple applications have access to the same data, to the same processes. And I described the data lake abstraction. So what we see as offerings in our IoT stack to abstract the data, as well, you see that in the business technology platform, things like HANA Cloud being able to connect to multiple data sources and provide data virtualization. And the last point about integration. So it's really about that integration. And I think that's a theme that you have seen from the Purdue model, as well as the ISA stack, that it's really about integrating and having a consistent architecture and a consistent data approach to make the consumption, whether it's from a business analyst or a data scientist or a business user, to provide them with the right amount of information integrated at the right level. Now we'll take a look at a walkthrough through the Enterprise Architecture Designer.
Great. So in talking about the intelligent digital supply chain, I wanted to call attention to a series of information that we have contained and developed out of our Enterprise Architecture Designer, which is available on our API Business Hub. So as part of the Industry 4.0 themes, we know that we have a variety of integrations between components and software and business processes. So the diagrams and some of these details, I'm sure, are really great because they allow us to go into understanding the details. And in this particular case, we're looking at a value flow that is describing plan to fulfill. And I'll zero in here a little bit to give some details. So we have the elements of the business steps from planning into procurement. We can drill into things like production and material flow, ultimately into warehouse management, transportation management, and get a good sense of all of these business steps and the products and interactions that they have. What's also really nice about this is using the process classification framework known as APQC. So it's an external reference. It's used by many of our customers and partners. It really allows us to speak in a common language when we are describing these business process steps, when we are talking about personas. So really helps in keeping that consistency. Another view that I wanted to quickly highlight besides the value flows in those business process steps is the architecture blueprint itself. So you can see for plan to fulfill, it has various elements that are part of it, centering on our digital core with S4HANA, usage of our cloud applications like global track and trace, digital manufacturing cloud, how plant connectivity interacts and interfaces our shop floor components to the cloud, to S4. Great depiction here of the reuse of our master data in Asset Central. So really nice to get an overall picture of the different components that are being used in this process. So if I drill into one of the elements of these business process steps, and I like to go into the manufacturing side, I can see produce components. And what's really nice is I get a quick preview of dependencies. In this particular case, I know I have a collaboration diagram that's defined, so I can click through the diagrams or I can drill in by selecting that business process step here. And I'm linked to a diagram that has a lot of great information in it. What you're seeing here with these various pools, and I'll drill into the pools themselves, is an actual representation of the systems. So in this case, starts with the S/4HANA system. S/4HANA system interfaces with cloud platform integration, and that helps move the data into our digital manufacturing cloud. Besides the definition or the description of the products themselves, you can see the multiple swim lanes within the pools. What's really nice about this is, as I drill in, I can see that these are defining the specific steps that each persona is responsible for. So I can see the interaction between the production supervisor, production operator, and how the production operator interfaces and interacts with the various systems on the shop floor, such as plant connectivity, and how other elements like asset intelligence network fit in the overall scheme. So if I walk you through the starting point here, a couple of additional details that I wanted to point out. So if we look at the starting process, I can really follow the flow. I see some information around the release of the production order within S4. What's great is I see all of these interface points, and I can get to the detailed level of the iFlows of the objects themselves. You can see here on the right, I've got a link to our API Business Hub. So if I follow this link, I can drill right into the specific iFlow and see what has been implemented in this iFlow. So these are the iFlows that you can download from our Business Hub that you can implement into your system. So really a great tool, a great resource to get into the details of this end-to-end interaction. And lastly, I think the part that I did want to close with is not only do we see the ability to link these applications, but as I mentioned at the start, this entire collaboration diagram and this flow is available in the API Business Hub for you to reference for your projects.
Great. Well, thank you. I hope you enjoyed that demo. So to wrap up, please do check out the additional sessions that we have. Session 116, Dominic Metzger and I go through some details of Industry 4.0. We're also available for the Ask the Experts session. Also call out a couple of important notes on the websites. Please take a look at our Enabling Technologies white paper, as well as our Digital Supply Chain white paper and links here. Please subscribe to the Learning Hub. Be a great way to catch up on all of the content in TechEd. And if you have any questions, please do feel free to reach out to me. Thank you again for joining this session.